the greatest show on earth, Real Freaks. Nelson, what do you have for the big grand finale tonight?
Well, boss, tonight's feature is called Haunted-Ween. This 1991 film was made in Bowling Green, Kentucky, using many of West Kentucky's university's professors and students. This movie is filmed with frat kids, Halloween masks, and murder. So if you like wispy mullets and tightrope jeans and all-over animal print sweaters, this movie's for you.
So it's 80s-rific is pretty much what you're telling
me. No, it's more 90s.
90s?
Yeah. Well, it's
but it sounds like a rollover from the 80s.
Well, it's a custom, you know, it's made in 91, so like a lot of those styles are still going.
They're still going?
Still,
so technically, these people aren't cool.
No,
they're on the wrong end.
Yeah, they're not
of
very,
the fashion statement.
No, it's not very fashionable at all. Okay. They don't have their colored, you know, their colored screen shirts. Stuff like that.
Yeah, well, you would know people who are on the wrong end of fashion statements.
Right.
Well, all right, go put the tape in.
Okay, I got the tape now.
Yeah, you actually have a tape this week. What's up with that?
We got money.
Eddie, you look pretty scary.
Hey, Eddie, remember the Sigma Phi shake? There you go, little brother. Now remember, that's a secret.
Here you go, Eddie. Keep the change and buy yourself a new mask.
Hey, Eddie, how's it going? Well, you have a good night. Oh, by the way, Eddie, nice mask. Looks real scary.
Killing time. We're so glad you came. Have a chilling, chilling time. Oh, welcome to the House of Horror.
Come on, Eddie, you know you're too young to work in the house. Maybe next year. Hey, you better get some sleep. Your mom said we have a lot of work to do tomorrow. I'm going on home. Hey, Eddie, I'll see you later.
Welcome to the House of Horror. 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 Blood. Death. Murder. Blood. Death. Murder.
Thank you. Eddie, we need to go away for a while.
Curious or confused? Get information or a pamphlet at most pharmacies or a health clinic. If you need help, see a doctor.
It is so hard to choose a good business from a phone book. There's not enough information. Why?
Don't let this happen to you. Shopping and Check-In can solve all your problems. You can find a service or an item you need and watch a video about it. Shopping and Check-In can also help you lose weight. Shopping and Check-In can also cut cans. Shopping and Check-In can fit under your bed. It's a free service with Insight Cable. Not only do you get Shopping and Check-In online, also it's on demand. Shopping and Check-In may not help you cut cans, help you lose weight, or fit under your bed.
If you don't want to get the LOL cats in the email, then don't give me email in the first place, because that's what I enjoy sending out. And then he brought up something about LOL dogs or LOL celebrities.
No, it's I can have cheeseburger.
I can has cheeseburger.
I can has cheeseburger.
Which I don't understand because cats are supposed to be pretty smart, so they should be able to spell.
You know, Steely Cat does watch you every night. He told me to say that. I saw it in the email. He says, Steely Cat's watching Brandon do stuff.
So that's what that was.
That's right.
Okay, moving on. Who are the foremen on this house?
I don't know.
Why are there heating ducts at the bottom of the house? And who puts large spikes in a room? Obviously, this was not an OSHA-approved haunted house.
Well, I mean, you did have candles with open flames. Didn't they not think any one of those candles could get knocked off by a scared kid and burn down that wooden house?
And, where did this kid get a machete? And he didn't have it when he entered the room.
No.
And he only appeared as if he wanted to scare her.
Yeah.
Not kill her. Yeah. But I guess he committed at the end to finish her off. Like a deal. You know, when this had been hit by a car.
Wait, so you tell me that you decapitate deers when you hit them with your car?
Well, yes, I can't have Bambi looking at me with those eyes. Those eyes. She looked at me with those eyes!
It's okay. Some of us don't have souls.
What?
I mean, plus you figure these kids will grow up to be a killer. I mean, look at his van. If there's one thing I learned, wooden paneling on the inside of your van spells serial killer rapist. Plus he already had a blanket and a pillow.
That's why I reupholstered my van.
Did you?
And do you think he sits in there, looking in the mirror, saying, would you do me? I do me hard.
He's like, woo, look at me, woo, woo.
Did you just tuck something?
No.
Mama? Mama? No. No, Mama. Mama.
No! time to go home, Mama.
Sisters, how are we? The Sigma Phis have always been in front of the rest. It is a pleasure to be your leader. All right, quit it. This letter is from our national headquarters. I rescued it from Bo Shu. Man, there was a hole in my shoe and the letter looked pretty thick, so I patched it up. Did you read the letter first?
What, are you kidding? He can't read.
I think I should read this letter. Dear Mr. Simmons, it is my job to inform you that although we would like to keep you as members of our national fraternity, it is difficult without your dues. In the past 6 months, we have received a total of $17.13. You are currently past due in the amount of $3,700.
Man, that is total bull****. I sent him a check last week.
How much?
$4.
If we do not receive your dues in full, we will be forced to revoke your membership as a national fraternity. You have 30 days to reply with your payment.
So I guess it's our last party.
Curtain to the Reverend.
Friends, the Lord has called upon me to call upon you. He said to me, he said, Kurt, there is a road that you must travel, and on this road you will find happiness, friendship, and brotherhood. Lord, help us.
Help us, help us, help us.
But this road, it cost money. It cost $3,700. So I ask you, help me find the way and dig down deep, deeper into your pockets and give me, your leader, $100 each.
Crazy!
Mel, it's good to see you finally made it.
Well, Kurt, I see your fraternity's in trouble, as usual.
What was that for?
I've missed you.
I just saw you this afternoon.
That's not what I mean.
Okay, then what do you mean?
Let's take a walk.
Thank you.
Thanks. Get listening in, Jack. We need to have a meeting in my room. 10 minutes. Make that 20.
Take me 30 seconds.
That's 18, dude. One more. I'm going home with her.
I don't mean to, Mel.
I know, but why can't we just do something sometime? We used to do a lot together before you became president.
I know. Being president takes a lot of time. I'm responsible for these guys. At least what's left of them.
Summer when you had to leave my family's vacation?
Yeah, my dad needed some help on the farm.
I know, and I can understand that, but it's always something.
So what's bothering you?
I guess I'm just jealous of your friends.
That's okay. That's normal. My friends are much cooler than your friends.
I'm serious, Kurt.
Look, I really like what I'm doing here. These guys mean a lot to me. One day we'll have a chance to do something for each other.
I know. But I love you. Even if you do ignore me half the time.
I'll try harder.
I'll try to be more understanding.
Tomorrow we'll go someplace. Just you and me. No fraternity.
That would be nice.
Let's go back inside.
All right, guys, we need to talk. This letter I read was really important. Let's get to the problem. We are going down unless we find some money fast.
Man, I wrote him a letter and told him we were having a few problems.
Well, Hanks, what did you say in the letter?
To whom it may concern. Man, we're having a few problems. Sincerely, Hank's treasurer.
Man, I don't know how you came to be treasurer.
Hell, listen, you nominated me.
I did? I did that? Hey, let's have a car wash.
Oh, man, I hate to wash my own car, much less somebody else's. Let's steal the car and sell it.
Guys, the last time we had a car wash, we only made $120.
We can rake the neighbor's leaves. It's that time of year.
Man, we're not in college to work. We're in college to use our minds. Let's rob a liquor store. Everybody does it.
Oh, yeah, right. And as far as raking leaves goes, our neighbors hate us. If they knew that we needed money, they'd probably find it all and hide it.
Well, that's a problem we need to think about.
Kurt, let's ask your dad if we can sponge some more money off of him. We'll pay him back.
Yeah, like we paid him back the last time and the time before that. My credit line is shot.
I got it. We've never charged anybody to get in our parties. Let's have a little fundraiser, hellraiser. We'll charge $3 a piece and everybody will come.
Well, I hate to charge people for a party.
Screw it, Kurt. Man, let's do it.
Jack?
It's our only choice.
Hanks, you're in charge. Meeting adjourned.
What? Man, this isn't fair! I've burned up all my brain cells thinking up the idea. Now I've got to do all the manual labor. Is anybody going to help me with this? This is bull.
They both smoked pot. That's jive talk for marijuana. And after a while, Ann and I got so that we did too. It's funny what it does to you. Everything speeds up to 100 miles an hour. You think you're real sharp, and you laugh a lot. You feel like you're the biggest person in the world.
Several weeks later, after smoking reefers, Marty's befogged brain hit on a clever way to open pop bottles. Later, Stan went to the hospital for swallowing broken glass. Marty badly cut the inside of his mouth, though he didn't even know it at the time. His perception of depth and dimensions is radically changed. A low curb appears as a precipice. With a distortion of sight and sound, time is suspended.
Jim Rex? What's Jim Rex? Would you believe a movie audience guide presented as a public service by this theater's management to help you select your motion picture entertainment? Well, that's what it is. And we urge you to learn these rating symbols and use them as a guide for you and your family. G means suggested for general audiences, all ages. M, suggested for mature audiences, parental discretion advised. R, restricted, persons under 16 not admitted unless accompanied by parent or adult guardian. X, persons under 18 will not be admitted. This seal in advertising indicates that the film was approved under the Motion Picture Code of Self-Regulation.
Care for a cup of Wilkins coffee?
No, I don't like coffee.
This has been a public service.
Oh, hey, Mark.
Hey, Mark.
Hey.
Where have you been?
I lost my cat.
Oh, that's not right.
Yeah, so I made this cat magnet to try and get it back.
Cool. Does it work?
Kinda.
Nice.
Yeah, but that's not my cat. Gotta keep working on it. See ya.
See ya.
Anything's possible. Keep thinking. Get started on your own inventions or just play some games at inventnow.org.
I did study dance. I did for a little while until they kicked me out. Because I was dirty dancing. And I told them, you can't put me in the corner. And there was a bunch of kids and a ruckus, and I started a whole movement, but that's not the point.
Yeah, well, every time in the lake, you constantly dancing with that man when he lifts you and parries you in the air. You learned that from school?
Dance partner. Don't try to turn it into something dirty.
I didn't say dirty. You were in the water. I mean,
Eduardo,
how dirty are you gonna
Eduardo
be?
Has strong, comforting arms, and I know I'm not coming down hard.
Oh, boy, it's good. That's good. I'm glad to hear
it. It is
that.
Good.
But I tell you, I'm confused.
No inhibitions.
I'm confused why anyone would want to attend any of these guys' party. Nevertheless, pay to attend. Do you see their party room with the speakers hanging from the ceilings? That seems like a recipe for disaster.
Yes, yes. And what does say rad party? Like beer bongs, bad puns, and you get to hear about the problems of the fraternity, financially wise. But, you know, at least they won't charge for a party to fix those problems. It's just not right. Why charge people money?
Exactly.
I'm drunk.
And when did beer goggles actually change the drink kit that you're drinking? I mean, in the movie, the girl is straight up holding an 800 OE 64-ouncer and turns it into some kind of martini glass? Man, that's some strong stuff.
Yes. And also, can we hear something by Kenny G, please? Maybe to set the mood, you know?
I mean, really?
It almost sounds like Jerry Lee Lewis as a former member of the Brotherhood, whatever you call those weirdos. And he's rocking out in the back room.
I mean, seriously, I mean, really, who is DJing this party? Wait, it looked like there were underage girls at the party anyway. Oh.
Who's that?
I'm not sure who that is.
He just walked through the set with a tape measure.
Hey, we can't do that anymore?
Well, no, we're filming the show. We don't want people walking through, especially people I've never seen at my carnival before.
Oh, well, you obviously don't keep a good hold on what people do around here. They're always just walking
Have you been
around.
Facebooking people again, telling them to stop by the show?
Yeah, they're very happy with it. They said, can we come out to the show? I would say, yeah, come out to the show.
I don't have a problem with them coming out to the carnival. That's money for me. When they walk in the middle of my show, it hurts business.
You need to put up a sign that says, we are taping. Please do not walk through the set.
Signs cost money that we don't have.
Hey, Melanie called about an hour ago.
Shit. I was supposed to call her. I'll just go pick her up. Jack, I'll give you a ride.
Cool.
Jack. You really think National will take our fraternity away?
Man, don't even worry about it. We'll make lots of money at the party. So what are you and Mel doing today?
I think we'll just go to the lake. I just gotta spend some time with her. You know how girls are.
Yeah, I know how women can be. Oh, so what are you trying to say? I don't know women? Thanks, Kurt. Thanks a lot.
We should do this more often.
See, Mel, this isn't so bad.
No, the sun feels great. It's nice, and you look great. Would you put some more on my back?
Sure.
No idea these guys are gonna be here.
Oh man, come on, let's go. I don't need any beer here.
Oh.
Yeah.
Let's get out of here.
All right.
Let's go, Dan. Guys.
With you. Go for a drive on the other side of the lake.
See if what you do, never done quite what you'd say. Can stay it never ripped mad in any way. That's alright. There will come a day.
What is it?
That house. I've seen pictures of it. It's the old Berber house.
Kurt, I was talking. Weren't you even listening to me?
Come on, let's look around.
God, it's spooky. Do you think anyone lives here?
Let's go find out.
This is a scary place.
Locked. Damn. Mel, I got an idea. This would make a great haunted house for a Sigma Phi fundraiser. Yeah.
You all right?
I cut myself on that screen.
Let me see. Hey, we better have someone take a look at this.
The Sigma Phi's proudly present the fundraiser Hellraiser with the Side.
My little flock of chickens. We love you. We love you. Just don't forget your money. Just don't forget your money. We got it all here. Hot women and cold beer, baby. Yeah, head on in. Hey.
May I help you?
Yeah, is this the fundraiser Hellraiser?
Do you have funds?
Three apiece, right?
$3?
That's okay, I got it.
Let's raise some hell, fellas, but I don't have any change. Raise some hell, fellas! You know, this whole party was my idea. What's your name?
Donna. Well, you must be real smart.
You're very perceptive, but mostly I'm wealthy. My daddy owns a money farm.
A money farm?
Yeah, we'll call $10 bills on the tree. Pick them off every spring.
That's baloney.
No, it's money. Here's a 10, but don't spend it for a couple of weeks. It's not ripe yet.
You're a funny guy. You want to walk me home later?
Oh, yeah.
The creation of an incredible new world, a world of unbelievable excitement and fun, the world of the Ding-a-lings. The Ding-a-lings, here they come, the whole fantastic bunch of them, the most incredible toys you've ever seen, all new, all different. Holy smoke, what's going on? It's Ding-a-ling Fireman coming to the rescue. He's got his own built-in pumper to save the day. Ding-a-ling Shoe Shine gives you the brightest shine you've ever seen. Ding-a-ling Spy hides in the shadows and discovers your secrets with his hidden camera. But wait, here comes the greatest ding-a-ling of them all, presenting King Ding, mighty ruler of the ding-a-ling world. What's this little guy doing? He's in King Ding's elevator and is riding up through the inner power plant. You see it all on the incredible closed-circuit TV screen built right into King Ding's back. Now he's getting close to the head. He's there. He becomes King Ding's actual brain. Watch him move his control levers and make the mighty King Ding go.
with boys all over America right behind him to help him perform his tasks and rule the ding-a-ling world. What makes all this fun and excitement in the ding-a-ling world possible? This, the ding-a-ling power pack. Just one power pack is all you need to make any of the ding-a-lings go. The most fantastic invention you've ever seen. It snaps in and out quickly and easily. With a price for the power pack and the ding-a-lings you find hard to believe. And that price will make it a year-round seller. The ding-a-lings, a whole new concept created for fun and excitement, complete with special skyways, vehicles, and accessories. And a $3 million TV campaign will introduce the world of the ding-a-lings for what it is, the most incredible fun idea ever to hit the toy market. Stand back, world. There's a whole new one on the way. The wild, wonderful, wacky world of the ding-a-lings.
That's why the women at Berkeley no longer allow me to talk to them. Because apparently, when you're streaking to the quad, they mean, let's streak to the quad if we're attractive. Apparently, they couldn't tell I was streaking. They thought I was Bigfoot. Well, a lot of hair.
You do realize that's where the terminology Birkenstocks come from, so they
Birkenstocks?
Were, they were, yeah, Berkeley Birkenstocks.
Like the big socks?
No, stocks.
Stocks?
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 No.
I stalked women at Berkeley.
Oh, that's
I'm a Birkenstalker.
Berkeley stalker.
Maybe I'm a Birkenstalker.
I'm totally lost on what you're talking about now.
Okay. Well, who was the talent scout for this movie? I have to ask that.
I mean, don't really know.
Did he sit down and say, I need a redneck Don Knotts.
Yeah.
I need the chin of Bruce Campbell, just the chin, not the acting talent. Great actor. And a poor man's Pee Wee Herman.
That's a movie right there.
Without the movie theaters.
And, you know, if no one has been to this farm, but obviously it looked like that road had been very well traveled, and then you decide to go off-roading with your vet.
Oh, yes, I bet the vet plant down at Bowling Green was very excited to see them destroy one of those beauties. Especially for the movie.
Also, if you're having problems with your girlfriend, is your only solution is to go and sunbathe, can't you take her to a nice restaurant? I mean, I think a Mirage was still open. It shouldn't have burned down before this movie was made.
Well, also, how long can you keep a woman who wants all your time and complains about your friend while you're wearing a Foot Locker Slam Fest shirt? Good luck, Kurt. That's an accomplishment.
It's actually, you have to be very accomplished to get one of those shirts. You just cannot walk into Foot Locker.
They don't just sell them?
No, you know.
Well, I'm sure they don't sell them anymore, but at the time, I'm sure I could have gotten a Foot Locker shirt if I wanted
one. You actually have to either participate in the event or buy it when you're at the event.
What is a Slam Fest?
It's where you play basketball.
A slam? What do you slam people?
Well,
that'd be more like a jam fest.
No, not a jam fest. You slam
no,
the ball.
Jam fest would be an affair with jams.
Not a lot of people.
What would be a good name
it?
For that?
Foot Locker Basketball Fest.
That would be better. That would be more accurate.
Right.
I mean, I don't bring people in here and say, hey, this is the Mary Kay Show. We're not selling makeup. We're making movies and watching movies.
But the thing with all the makeup you wear to hide all your scars, they figure maybe we are selling makeup. Mary Kay. Isn't that why you got that pink car?
Don't look in my bathroom anymore.
Oh, the pink car's just your feminine side now, huh?
It's okay. It was red, and it was faded by the sun. It's not my fault that God wanted me to have a pink car, apparently.
You still drive it, so obviously...
I drive it because it matches my shoes.
Did you get those from Mary Kay, too?
I'm done with you.
Okay.
So what's up with you and Kurt? Oh, we're just fine. Come on, Mel. We've been friends for what, 7 weeks? What's the scoop? Oh, it's this fraternity. These guys mean more to him than I do.
I'm telling you, that is the way it is with these guys. The apes have been that way forever.
But I love him, and I want to spend more time with him.
You want my advice? Dump his ass. Just forget him. Find somebody else. You're too young to be miserable, and if he really gave a crap about you, he'd fight for you.
Sally, I can't do that.
Why not?
Because we've been dating for 6 months.
Dump him.
But I don't think
I should... I think that you should dump him. Look, he'll follow you. Believe me, I know guys. The turd heads.
Down.
this alone. The haze is stretch of black. You're sleeping home and he ain't never coming back. One more trip on Susan. One more trip on Susan.
You're crying. Why are you crying?
Kurt, we need to talk. Don't you get it? Nothing has changed.
Jack, take over.
Can we come into the party?
Are you girls over 18? I'm talking years, not days.
Are you 18? I'm 18. I'm 18. We'll never get in. Yes.
$3 each. Come on in. Youngster.
Hey, Hanks, how we doing?
Oh, excellent. Another 1,200 people and we got this thing licked.
Hey, I need some money to buy a keg.
Man, I just gave you $40 a few minutes ago.
I know, but we need another keg.
Every time we get ahead, we need another keg.
I know it, Hanks, but if we don't have beer, then the party will die down. And if we don't have a party, then we can't make any money.
Have a good time.
Thanks, guy.
$3.
I'm not here to party.
Man, don't close us down. We're just having a little fundraiser.
And I want to help.
Can you write us a check for $3,700?
There's an abandoned house outside of town, near the lake. Make a great haunted house.
That's the Berber house.
Yes.
Man, that place has been closed for years. Nobody gets in.
Here. This will get you in. You may use it with my permission.
Who are you?
I'm a Sigma Phi, just like you.
Brother, give me the shake.
Did I remember?
Huh?
That was the correct shake, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah, that was fine.
I hope you make lots and lots of money.
I didn't get your name, brother.
Good luck, brother.
Thanks. I'll tell the guys.
Mel, wait, come back. Why are you doing this?
Man, what is her problem?
I don't know.
Well, check this out. Some dude just came by and gave me the key to the Berber house.
Hey, I was just out there today. I was telling Liston and Jack we ought to have a haunted house there.
What a coinkydink. The guy that owns it said we could use the house. This will solve our money problem forever.
That place has been closed forever. How can we get in?
I give you the key to hell. This will be a killer haunted house.
Who was this guy?
Man, he's an alumni, but who cares anyway? We'll go out there, set up a haunted house. It's October, we'll just count the cash.
And this guy didn't want anything?
No, sometimes people just like to do nice things for other people. Makes them feel good about themselves. I learned that in Psychology 311.
This is it. So this guy just walks up to you and gives you a key to this house.
That guy was full of shit, man. That key is not gonna work.
Man, that guy was for real. He was spooky, but he was for real. He's an alumni. He wants us to make some money, fellas.
I believe you, Hanks.
So, Kurt, I heard what Mel did last night. How come she broke up with you?
For one, we didn't break up. She said she wanted some space, so I'm giving it to her.
Oh, and you don't call that a breakup?
Of course not.
So, what is she? Seeing somebody else?
I don't know, maybe. It's fine with me.
Well, maybe I'll take her out.
Jiggle it, Jack. Play with it, like you've been doing the last 4 weeks. Real effective. Voila. Well, I'm so glad he gave us the key. Man, with some paint, some lights, all this would be a killer haunted house.
Hell, screw the paint, man. Just bring some people in here and let them stand around. That'll be scary enough.
No kidding. I'm so scared I gotta take a leak already.
Man, I get to feeling some really scary shit went on here at one time.
This place is perfect. Kinda reminds me of myself.
When Snubby Gunn plays Private Eye, and you can have the same kind of fun with Mattel's Tommy Burst Detective Set.
The Tommy Burst has automatic bolt action. Fire off a burst of 10 shots. Pull the bolt again, you're reloaded. Or fire single shots like a rifle. The Tommy Burst alone is $3. In the Detective Set, you also get the Snub Nose 38 and Snap Draw Shoulder Holster. The pistol fires greeny stick'em caps and shoots safe shooting shells. The exciting new Tommy Burst Detective Set includes wallet, badge, and ID card. $7 wherever toys are sold. You can tell it's Mattel. It's swell.
Then you go rock, paper, scissors.
Rock, paper,
rock,
scissors?
Paper, but you gotta switch over to the paper. And really? I mean, really? This is getting out of hand. Who are these people? Don't they realize we're doing a show? I mean, should we reshoot? Should we reshoot?
Just keep going. Just keep rolling.
Seriously?
Yeah, keep rolling.
Has our budget dropped this much that we're watching how much tape we use now? I mean, yeah, fine.
I don't know.
Whatever, just moving on. Moving on. Movie magic editing, whatever.
Boss, why are they selling tickets to this event? You could easily sneak into the event. I mean, did you see any fences in the backyard? So, no, why not walk in?
Well, really, who would want to sneak into this party? Look how bad the band is. I've never heard of someone called The Side.
Well, you know, if they were like the Radioactive Flowers, I would have stayed to watch. And why did Hank ask the girls if they are 18? So let me get this. You're more concerned about not getting in trouble for statutory rape than you are about serving alcohol to minors?
I mean, yeah, that's uncalled for. And why does the killer need to give the key to the old house for them to make a haunted house? And how did he know it would be Sigma Pi? What about SAE, Farmhouse, or the dreaded Kappa Sigmas?
Actually, they are SAE, but they hid the lions in the front yard by making them look like elephants. It's weird. I would have used the Kappa Sigma house. You know, they stayed at an old funeral home and they partied in the embalming room.
Makes for a sticky situation.
Hey, there's nothing like naked beer slides to end a great party.
Naked beer slides? Is that like the pizza box game?
No.
Don, you totally were telling me good. About? Whether,
yeah, when well, you, thing write, and you the... write the thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
No, it's you're completely forgetting about the
maybe I'm thinking of something else.
No.
I'm thinking of a different game.
You should try a naked beer slide. You know what
naked
that is?
Naked beer slide, what is that?
It's what you do is you get a keg and you pour beer in a room. Usually it's
I'm
like-
I'm listening.
And then you run naked and you slide through the beer.
Are there women that do this?
No, every time we did it, it was just guys. You could do women. I mean, if
there's not something to. Waiting for you at the end, like a slip and slide.
No, it's the beer is a slip in the slide.
The slip and the slide, but you know, at the end of the slip and slide, there was the alligator.
They were actually
waiting for you. I'm just making sure.
No.
So what you're telling me is there's a bunch of men naked sliding around on beer along a line, and there's somebody waiting at the end for you?
No, it was maybe a concrete wall.
Concrete wall.
Maybe it wasn't the safest thing.
Must have been something hard.
Well, I did it last night.
I know, I heard.
You know, I'm still not sure if it was the right thing to do. He's been under a lot of pressure lately with this fundraising thing.
Look, I'm telling you, if he really loves you, he'll come back.
You think so?
I know so. Trust me. Do you know where they are right now?
Where?
They're at the Berber house. Some guy came by last night, gave him a key, and told him they could have a haunted house in order to raise the money.
Maybe if everything goes well, then Kurt will have more time for me.
I'm sure he will. But he's not the only guy around.
Yeah, I'm finding that out.
Zip it, zip it, zip it, zip it! Welcome to hell, my friends. Nails?
Nails!
Paint?
Paint!
And most important, beer! What more could a guy ask for?
Permission!
Who invited him? Hi, Sheriff.
Just what in the hell are all of you doing out here anyway?
We're just having a little fundraiser haunted house for the community.
You do have permission to be here, don't you?
Oh, yes, sir. We've got the key. That's permission.
A key? A key to the Berber house? Who the hell would give you a key to this place?
Well, it fits the lock.
Are you getting smart with me, frat boy?
Oh, no, sir. I'm not a smart person.
Fraternity project, huh? You know, I know how these things can get out of hand, especially when it's a Sigma Phi project. That's why I'm going to keep an eye on each and every one of you the whole time you're out here. And frat boy, don't mess with me on this one.
Let's do it!
Yeah!
Start the show. We're just dying to start the show. In a haunted house on a haunted wing, the ladies wait to hear you scream. He's well rehearsed, he likes his role. Jason's dying to start the show. Someone's dying to start the show. Start the show.
Okay, who ordered the pizza?
No, I'm so sorry. Yeah,
just put them over there. We'll get to them. Bill, pay the man.
Thanks.
Me.
Freebird, man.
Well, what song is it that y'all want to hear?
Freebird.
If I leave here tomorrow, would you still remember me? That's all I know.
I got one.
Well, I don't know why I keep on believing that she loves me when I know it's not true. Maybe my leaving would be the thing to do. But my rose-colored glasses that I'm looking through show
got a great idea. Let's tell ghost stories.
Tell us a true story.
Okay. Well, as you all know, my daddy's the sheriff. Come on, you guys, I'm serious. Well, anyway, about 20 years ago on this very property, a little girl was murdered in that haunted house. Hey, I'm serious. Well, this house used to be a great place for families to go. But one night, they found a little girl in one of those rooms. They found her head cut off, and a monster mask laying beside it. Blood was everywhere.
Well, people get murdered all the time.
I'm not finished, Butthead. Anyway, the mother who owned this house disappeared that night with a little boy. And no one's heard from him since.
Maybe he got murdered, too.
Or maybe he's the one that killed the little girl. Yeah, and he's still on the loose.
Now, that is scary.
Well, my daddy says the little boy did it. He talked to a lot of people that night. He said the little boy was really weird. He was into monsters and all that creepy stuff.
Well, I don't believe any of it. I mean, I think the girl cut her own head off.
Right.
And now she's trying to pin the rap on the little boy.
Nobody would cut their own head off.
Well, speaking of head. Let's go swimming.
I don't have my suit.
I don't want to go swimming with your swimsuit, Joanne.
Well, in that case.
We'll be at the lake if anybody needs us.
You want to go for a little dip?
Well, I didn't bring my suit.
You don't see Flipper wearing no suit.
Well, I'm not Flipper. And anyway, we've got class tomorrow. Why don't we just sit here and enjoy the fire?
Okay.
So, does anybody want another beer?
Yeah,
Ben.
Yeah.
Joanne, this is my favorite part of every movie.
Oh, you like this? Are you sure you want to go swimming? It's probably cold.
Well, sure, I'm sure. I mean, aren't you sure?
Well, sure, I'm sure. I just wanted to make sure you were sure.
Sure.
We got it. We got it.
You got what?
We found a way to put Simonite car wax
and Simonite car cleaner all in one push-button can.
And just how does it work, Professor Nitwit? Come on, we'll show you.
Come on, we'll show you.
Come on, with.
Now look, it squirts on. You push the button. See?
See?
And then what? You spread it around and let it dry.
And it's really Simonite, is it?
Watch this.
Sure it's Simonite. Look at that shine.
We'll be famous. We'll make a fortune. We'll call it, Instant Simonize.
Instant Simonize, you lame brains. You can already buy Instant Simonize everywhere.
Instant Simonize? They thought of it, too?
Simonize thinks of everything. Try Instant Simonize, another easy new way to brighten your day. From Simonize Company.
Need your plumbing fixed fast?
Montage.
Need to overthrow a dictatorship?
Montage.
Need to make a haunted house quick?
All you need is a montage. Hey, how does group agree to listen to a guy sing the only note was one note on his guitar?
And Freebird. That's what they request?
Mm-hmm.
I would figure that this master exploder could pull off a rendition of Eruption from Van Halen. But you know, Freebird, that's nice playing, brother.
Hey, you know what? What's his brotherhood like hooking up with the fraternity leader's ex-girlfriend just a day or so after they break up in front of everyone?
And this incredible Axeman decides to head out for a swim with his lady, but needs to give a thumbs up to everyone to explain that he's gonna get lucky.
You know, I found it remarkably strange that there's fog coming from the water, though this would indicate the water is warmer than the air, which still would make the water pretty cold.
And how does a big lumbering guy like him, with a mask on, sneak up behind someone without them noticing? He just pops out of nowhere like a ninja.
And why wearing a mask? It's not like anyone knows who he is.
Well, I mean, sometimes the mask accentuates the experience. I know there's certain things I enjoy doing with a mask on.
Yeah, but, I mean, it's still, why would you need to wear a mask? I mean, first of all, guess what? They never see him. He's always popping up behind him. So why wear the mask?
Stimulation.
Role-playing. Helps him?
I think he might be one of those guys who can't kill unless he has the mask on, you know what I'm saying?
So it's a aid for him.
Yes, it is an aid.
Aid.
It's like Cialis for serial killers. Putting that mask on makes it to where they're ready to go and kill people.
So it's confidence booster. It's like,
I know what Cialis does.
I could go kill them. You seen the commercial, it makes you throw a football through a hoop. Or a tire.
Yeah, let's go with that. Yeah, that's why I take it, footballs.
Haven't you seen it? It's football through the tire.
Through a tire?
Yeah.
That's actually pretty accurate.
And apparently it could cause blindness and maybe death in certain cases. If you don't see a doctor, if you keep throwing footballs.
Hey, come to the haunted house.
Haunted house.
It'll be really scary.
Thank you. One night only.
It's scary. Come to the haunted house tonight.
Scary right. Friends.
Signifies haunted house. Be there.
Yeah. Come all to the haunted house. We got free admission. We got free parking. Only $5.
Man, Hanks, I'm really pumped. This will be enough to cover that bill to Nationals.
Here you go. Welcome to the House of Horror.
We'll see you there. You know, this whole thing is just really weird, though. Don't you think?
What do you mean?
Well, the whole thing. This guy comes over and gives us permission to use the house, the keys. It's all so easy.
Man, look at it this way. You're some poor slob bum laying in the gutter. You got that drool coming out of your mouth. Some lady gives you a $5 bill. You'd be the type of person sending a thank you note.
Yeah, you always have the way of putting things into proper perspective.
I'll tell you something's weird, though. Joanne and Ferris never came back from the lake last night.
They didn't?
No, they went skinny dipping. Maybe they weren't skinny enough.
Man, you know how those two are. They're like rabbits. Hey, where'd Mel sleep?
Oh, she slept by Bozo, but don't worry about it. They didn't do anything. I kept my eyeball on them last night.
Good.
I see a couple of things I need to attend to, Junior. We'll see you later.
All right.
Hey, the house looks great.
Yeah, thanks for your help.
Are you mad at me?
Why? Should I be?
I don't know. You seem like you don't want to talk to me.
Well, I thought I was giving you the space you wanted. Why don't you go talk to Bentley?
Well, maybe I'll just do more than talk.
What would it cost to take a cab from New York City to Los Angeles? Joe?
$5,000.
Is it $5,000, $500, or $55,000? Julie?
From here to New York?
$5,000. John, what do you think?
$5,000.
At current rates, a cross-country cab fare would be more like $5,000.
Yeah!
Julie gets a spin, John goes to four, Joe gets three.
So how are you and Mel getting along?
What position do you play hey, in baseball if you win I don't even want to get into this whole thing with you, Kurt.
Well, you're right in the middle of it, like it or not.
Kurt, no offense, but she told me the whole story. You don't pay enough attention to her.
You listen to me, you little bastard. She's confused, and she just needs some room to think. So why don't you just back off?
You're right. You're absolutely right. I wasn't gonna do anything, but now I think I'll bone her.
Man, you're not even worth it.
Well, you didn't buzz in, you didn't get an answer in there.
How many?
Three.
Yeah. Comfy? About the stowaways.
Oh. I didn't even know they're back there.
25.
That's a lot of money, isn't it?
Bud, you're gonna see some things tonight you have never, ever seen.
Hey, Hanks, how we doing?
Unbelievable, man. We should have a haunted house every week.
Excellent, Hanks. Keep it up.
Keeping it up is no problem.
Is this going to be one of them really scary, scary haunted houses?
Yes, yes, it is.
It better be.
Welcome to Haunted-Ween. Chills, thrills, and kills are on tonight's agenda.
Yo, shows me how things going. Man, I have never seen more girlies in one place in my life. But I want to be inside on the wall of hands, man.
Hey, dudes, three girls.
Stand against the wall.
Screaming makes me tense and I lose my patience! Anybody need a wart burned off? I make a few mistakes. It's a medical practice.
Next.
I've got to go to the bathroom. Can you guys handle the next group?
Sure, we'll handle them.
Cute. Real cute.
Refresh yourself. It's intermission time. The concession stand is open and ready to serve you. It's intermission time, folks, so hurry, hurry, hurry. Step right over to our refreshment center for the most extravagant array of refreshment goodies ever assembled under one roof. Enjoy breathtaking, mouth-watering goodies, everything from a snack to a delicious full meal. At our refreshment center, you'll find a large variety of goodies to satisfy your hunger, your thirst, or your sweet tooth. So hurry, hurry, hurry. Visit our refreshment center now.
Hi, folks. I'm Rico.
Oh, Nacho.
He's Peppy.
Si.
You can find us at the concession stand in the lobby.
Along with all sorts of other tasty goodies.
Si.
Rico's Nachos, a refreshingly new and different snack discovery. Chock full of high-quality ingredients, crisp, fresh tortilla chips, covered with creamy aged cheddar cheese, topped off with zesty jalapeno pepper rings. Rico's Nachos, out of sight.
Remember, folks, we're the new star at the snack bar. Rico's Nachos, a new taste treat you can't beat.
See?
Rico's Nachos, on sale at the snack bar now.
You getting on the Wilkins Coffee bandwagon?
Never.
No! You either go with Wilkins or you just don't go.
What is the deal with all this product placement in these movies? It ruins the authenticity. It just feels wrong.
You know, I figured the movie makers want to show off the local products, you know, from their locations. Ooh, pizza.
But it feels forced, like they're trying to cram it down your throat about local products and things like that. I mean, it just doesn't feel natural.
Yeah, but you figure they want to celebrate, you know, local culture and things like that.
It just seems cheap. That's all I'm saying. I mean,
yeah, you know, I bet you're asking yourself, why Bowling Green, Kentucky? Well, you know, John Carpenter, maker of the Halloween, he moved to Bowling Green with his dad. And they were, his dad apparently was the music professor down in Western Kentucky. So later on, Carpenter transferred to USC to finish his studies in filmmaking. And if you watch the movies, Halloween 1 and 2, there were specific locations like Smith's Grove, Warren County, and Bowling Green. But the entire movie was made in California.
So what you're telling me is this movie is just an homage to John Carpenter.
Yes. They tried. But, you know, they weren't successful.
Successful. Successful. That's the word.
Yes.
Okay.
Specific.
No way.
Decision! Sit and spin! How's your boyfriend? What about you? You ready to get down?
Yeah.
You ready to come down? Shut up! You ready to come out? You ready to come out? Yeah. Yeah. A little close there, huh, buddy? Hit the ball! A little close there, huh?
Drop your arm.
Hit him!
Are you about ready for a beer?
That'd be great. Get me one, too.
Cool, we'll be right back.
The shit we go through for these guys.
Listen, man, this thing is really going great.
Hell yeah, man. Bet you we've made enough money already.
Beautiful.
Well, thank you, brother. Nice match.
You know, this haunted house stuff is hard work.
That it is. Look, this isn't very private. I think everyone's got this under control. Why don't we slip outside?
Okay.
My van's parked out back. I'll meet you there in 10 minutes.
What am I doing? So real. Strike
Maybe it's time we go through.
Sounds like too much fun.
That kill room. God, that was really scary.
Woo.
That gave me a myocardial infarction.
This cool mask in the house. Man, you scared the shit out of me.
Hey, aren't you supposed to be at the house?
I'm taking a little break. Mel's coming out to join me.
Mel? You and Mel got something going?
Not with you around, dead. Get out of here.
Well, okay, but you owe me a good story later.
Jack, I gotta go. I'll see you later.
You don't want to see the rest of the house?
I've got to take care of something. Excuse me. Pardon me. Excuse me. Excuse me.
Mel, wait a minute.
I want to talk to you.
I didn't think we had anything to talk about.
Look. I've been trying to give you the space you wanted.
And I appreciate that, and I figured some things out.
Me too. I love you.
You mean it?
I do. I really do.
Sally was right. She told me you'd chase me.
I just didn't know how much you meant to me until I thought I'd lost you.
Kurt, you never lost me. You had me the whole time. You just didn't know it.
Use new Blue Ajax cleanser. Get you out of the kitchen fast.
Look, pot marks take the time. Even steel wool can't do the job. But watch Ajax with blue chlorine. Just a soft sponge and pot marks gone fast.
Honey, all I did was...
Get out of the kitchen fast. Get Ajax now in plastic, too.
Okay. So they took this old house and turned it into a haunted house. But for some reason, they decided they need to remove the boards from the windows. I mean, doesn't it look scarier that way?
What about Eddie? No one realizes there's an extra room, with a guy doing some kind of like weird pose. All the time, wouldn't one of the frat guys wonder about a new room that no one created?
Well, you can see they really don't care about the details. I mean, you figure if two people who are helping work on the house went swimming and then never came back to finish the job, you know, they'd notice. And they didn't really have specific roles for the house, like a ghoul or a damsel in distress, and no one seemed to care about the missing frat brothers or that.
I don't understand why a guy would dress up like a member of the Village People and try to scare people. Only thing he's missing is like a Freddie Mercury mustache.
And who is going to stop this killing machine? He's knocking guys' heads off with baseball bats and scoop slamming women while they're peeing.
What about Dayman?
Dayman?
Yeah, he's fighter of the Nightman. He's champion of...
The Sun?
Yeah, he's master of karate.
And friendship for everyone.
Dayman.
Dayman? Ah!
He's the fighter of the Nightman.
Ah!
He's the champion of the Sun.
He's the master of karate and friendship for everyone.
Dayman, come on with me. Dayman.
Dayman. Fighter of the Knights, man.
That's fun. So you like that.
Champion of the Sun.
Yes.
What are we doing? We've never broken out into song before.
Not together. I've heard you late at night, though.
What's this movie doing to us? I mean, I feel funny now. I feel pretty.
Maybe we can go on Broadway and do this.
Oh, so pretty. I feel pretty and witty and gay.
See, once again, break out a song.
No, that was more spoken word. Oh, it was like a poetry jam or whatever they call it.
This be my idea and all, I should at least get to see the mother.
Thank you. Everyone, stop him! Stop him! He's killing us! This is real! Dad! You bastard! You prick!
God, Hanks, you okay?
I got him. I cooked him like one of Mama's home-cooked biscuits. Son of a bitch!
You're gonna be fine, Mel.
I love you, Kurt.
I know. Mel.
nobody could have ever seen. Gonna raise some hell, gonna lose control. We're just dying to start the show. We're just dying to start the show. In a haunted house on a haunted wheel. The ladies wait to hear you scream. Well-rehearsed, he likes his role. Someone's dying to start the show. Someone's dying to start the show. Start the show.
Hey! This is my show! No smoking! It's a nasty habit. You know what? You know, I want to know who you are! No, don't get on your phone! Turn around! Do you see the blatant disrespect? Let's just finish up the show so I don't have to deal with it anymore.
That was... Ugh.
Are you okay?
I'll
get you a fresca afterwards.
Okay, that's fine.
Okay. Now, the part of the show we all enjoy. Questions, comments, and concerns.
Okay, why did the killer really need to hide his face with a mask? It's not like anyone would have known who he was. Plus, he just snuck up on him like a ninja.
Like a ninja.
Ugh.
And I really can't believe that you can blow up a van with a shotgun blast. Was the engine in the back? Were there gas barrels? Did they use incendiary rounds?
Okay, how did the 20 years later version of Eddie fit in the same size vent? I mean, he looked like he barely fit in them when he was a kid.
Do you really have to declare that something looks so real when it's just people sitting around a room? Yes, it is real. They are living people. Do you think they're using animatronics?
They look so real. And they really made a documentary video?
I guess.
And a music video? Man, where could I find them?
How strong is Eddie? He can lift a man up with one arm and stab him with a machete. He can cram a baseball into someone's mouth with no problem and then knock his head off like he was Barry Bonds. That's a strong man.
And you think we need to test old Eddie for the juice?
Well, I think it was from chopping wood.
And did the editor think that maybe this one guy yelling, "Hang him, let him hang," was so convincing that they repeat the same scene twice?
Yes, yes. And when did a fraternity start to let frat girls in? There are no frat girls. They're either little sisters or they are girlfriends. Or they're the girls who take the walk of shame every Sunday morning. That's from my apartment as well as a walk of shame.
Oh, yeah, really? What happened?
Yeah.
All right. I think he's still here.
Who is this man?
All right. You didn't hear about the news?
What news?
Well, apparently we've been sold. Well, I don't want to say
How have we been sold?
It's not really sold.
I didn't sell the show. I didn't sell the carnival.
Well, this guy came up one day.
Where's the deed?
And he says, you don't have it. But this guy came up
and he
said, "Hey, you guys have a great place." And I said, "I can't give it away. Jacob would be mad." And he said, "We're not going to
play." Yeah, you can't give away my show because you're not legally entitled to it.
But he said, "But I bet I can beat you at a game." I said, "I bet not." He said, "I will put up two cookies for your thing. If you beat me, you'll give me two cookies." I said, "What a deal." So they broke out Tiddlywinks. And I'm like, "I love Tiddlywinks. I'm going to win this game." I didn't win the game.
What you're telling me is you gambled away the carnival and show that I've spent my entire lifetime building for the hope of getting two cookies?
Two cookies, yeah. And they said maybe they'll throw in some milk. So I thought, that kind of sweetened the pot.
No, wait. What kind of cookies?
They're Oreos, so at least I had...
They weren't even full-size cookies?
No, they're little Oreos, two little Oreos, and maybe some milk.
Were they double stuffed?
No, they were just regular Oreos. They weren't like minty or anything. They were just regular Oreos.
So that still doesn't explain who this man is.
Well, he's now the guy who's in charge of the place. He owns it. So, and the thing is he said he's making a bunch of changes too. He wants
What kind of changes?
Like, he wants to go in like a new direction. Maybe like a more of a regional feel or something like that. He feels it's too local. So
too local?
Too local.
We have a very devoted fan base.
But he said, we need to be bigger.
Bigger?
Yeah.
Bigger, he says.
Yeah
I'm talking to you.
Get back with you. Let me get back with you, okay?
Yeah. Let me get back with you. You're just gonna sit there, talk on your fancy cell phone. I'm sorry, I have to use the payphone outside. I'm still a businessman. You could show me that much respect. So what you're telling me is that, hey, what do you know? That's my hat? I highly advise that you give me back my hat.
Yeah, that fits pretty well. Me, I get to be the host?
You're in charge.
Yes! You get to do the puke cleanup now, buddy!
Season on Real Freaks. Who is this new owner? What will Jacob do since he doesn't own the carnival? Will Joel and Nelson make it to superstardom? And who the hell is this guy? All these questions and more will be answered next season on Real Freaks.